defines an introvert as a person whose personality is characterized by introversion, a typically reserved or quiet person who tends to be introspective and enjoys spending time alone. Hey guys, Abigail of the Black Book Space. Today we are going to be talking about five wonderful ways that you, an introverted business owner, can be successful in business without changing your personality. So I have five wonderful ways. Number four is my absolute favorite. I don't know why I always put number four as my favorite, but I want you to stick around, check that one out with me. If you have any suggestions for other ways, I want you to comment those down below so we can all help each other out. Come back in a moment so we can talk about these methods. I am most definitely an introvert. I'm a pretty shy person, pretty quiet and reserved until I really feel I have to stand up for something. I'm finding my voice a lot more, but I've come up with some ways that really help me out when it comes to business. So the first way how to keep growing your business, be true to yourself as a business owner, even if you are more of an introvert, is to set boundaries and to stick to said boundaries. So a lot of people who may be a little more extroverted, they want to take up your time by calling you really late at night or calling your personal number when you have a business number. If that is something that you do not stand for, you can set that boundary so that people don't overstep it. So it's not just about setting boundaries, it's about setting boundaries and sticking to those boundaries. So if you have a set time where you turn off your phone and don't answer, people will learn that is a boundary that they cannot cross. Don't let it be a fluid boundary either. Let it be nice and strong. Set that boundary for yourself and for others so that people know how to treat you. Sometimes as introverts, we have a difficult time speaking up for ourselves because we may think that the person may not like us or they may not come back. But setting that boundary really sets you up for success because it sets a standard for how people will treat you. That's really important for introverts, extroverts, or ambiverted people. It's just important for everybody, so I highly suggest it. Set your boundaries and stick to them. Another really great way to succeed in business as an introvert, this is for anybody really, is to stick to your why. Come up with the reason why you started your business and stick to that. Allow that to keep you going. If you started your business for financial freedom, if you started it because you really wanted to help people with literacy, with weight loss, with anything like that, think about that constantly because that'll keep you going. It'll keep you inspired to keep going. Even if you are feeling really afraid of doing something out of your comfort zone, which is where we grow best, mind you, thinking of that will help you. It's going to help you keep going. I have to do that a lot. There have been so many times where my belly dance class wasn't growing as fast as I wanted to, or people were, you know, not making me feel the most comfortable in my own space. I really had to go back to why. Going back to why and defining why I started that class, or why I even started a new class, a meditation class, really helped me to redefine the way that I would market the class. It helped me define the way that I would show up in the class. When I began to show up differently in the class, people began to show up differently for me too, and I'm sure that's the same that will happen for you as well. So number two is to remember your why, your purpose for having started your beautiful business. And that'll take you out of that shy phase, and you'll be able to show up for yourself a lot easier when you have that purpose in place and you keep your eye on that purpose. Number three and number four are kind of related, but you know, they're separate too. So number three is don't overdo it. Sometimes as introverts, we kind of feel like we have to overdo it because those extroverted people seem to have all the fun and they seem a lot more charismatic. Everyone is charismatic in their own way. People are drawn to people for whatever reason. Don't overdo it. Always remain true to yourself. You don't have to be a lot more loud or flashy. People will come and it's time for them to come. Everyone's supposed to be there for a reason. And this is advice that I've been receiving over time that's really helped me out. And I know that when I stick to my purpose, and when I decide to do something and I'm consistent with it, rather than going insane and maybe posting 20 videos on YouTube when I only need to post one or two every other day or whatever my schedule will be, and staying consistent with that, when I stick to what I'm doing rather than overdoing it, I have a lot more energy to do the things that I decided to do from the beginning. So I highly suggest that. Have a schedule, stick to it, don't overdo it. It's completely unnecessary. Are we ready for number four. I wish I had brought my little prop with me because this one is all about rest. And my prop would have been the amazing book, Rest is Resistance. Number four is get plenty of rest. As an introvert, sometimes we get overwhelmed by other people's energy. There's just so much going on, we don't even have time to think. If this is you, you're not alone. One of the best ways to recharge is to get plenty of rest. And that means whatever it means for you. If it means you have to go get a pedicure, get a massage, actually go home and get a nap, get your 8 hours, 12 hours, how much time that you need to rest, get that rest. Do some meditation. Go around people who help to fill your cup. Don't be afraid to do that. Just because you are a business owner does not mean that you don't have time for rest. One of the reasons many of us go into business is for financial freedom. If you aren't working on feeling that financial freedom right now, like we talk about in the Law of Attraction, then feeling it in the future is gonna feel just as anxious. Don't feel anxious. Get your rest. Sit and visualize your business flourishing. Take some deep breaths when you get somewhere early. Don't rush around everywhere. Get your rest. Rest is resistance. You know, we're resisting the system. Rest is resistance. Get your rest. So that's why number four is my favorite, because I love my rest. I love my time where I can just relax, sip some really good water, some coconut water, eat some really good food, and just sit in silence. It's such a restorative practice, and I highly recommend it. Number five can be hard because, you know, as an introverted person, we're probably pretty shy, and sometimes we have to talk to people, and it's a little nerve-wracking, but every time I do, when I talk to someone who I don't really know or I'm intimidated by, it always turns out a lot better than I thought anyway. So this leads to the fifth one, which is delegating where you can. If you know someone who's really fantastic at something, ask them to help you out. You know, partake of their services. Ask them how much they charge for putting your YouTube channel together or putting your actual YouTube videos together, or how much they charge for greeting the people in your class. If you're nervous about doing that, if you need someone with you, ask for help. Don't be afraid to ask for help. It's so wonderful to have a group of people that you can bounce ideas off of. I have several groups of people that I can do that with, and it's so, so helpful. Sometimes you can delegate things to other people. Virtual assistants are absolutely amazing. They're wonderful people. You can pay for their services and they'll do things for you that they may be a lot more adept at than you are. So if they have a way to send out wonderful marketing emails and they're good at that and you can pay them, there's nothing wrong with delegating that out, because that saves you time to do the things that you really like to do. The more you do the things that you enjoy in your business, that joy and that love goes in there and it just flourishes and it's beautiful and delicious and juicy, and we love that. And it takes away the struggle. We talked about the other week, remember, that struggle is not cute. So those are the five reasons I have for you, the five ways that I have for you how to grow your business as an introvert. You don't have to do anything insane. Of course, growing a business may take you out of your comfort zone a little bit, and you'll grow, be a little uncomfortable a bit, but there's nothing wrong with that. These ways have really helped me a lot. These methods have helped me a lot, and I wanted to share them with you today. So comment below what your favorite method was of the five ways to grow your business successfully as an introvert, and I will see you next time. Bye. Do something that brings you